Hey guys, how are you all? My name is Harshad Devedi, friends, and I welcome you back to my video. So in the previous video, friends, I talked to you regarding the Balwant Rai committee report on Panchayati Raj reforms. I've told everything in detail about it because this was the first committee which recommended the establishment of the Panchayati Raj system in India. So that is why I detailed it in a separate video. Now in this video, friends, I will be combinedly telling you about the committees like Ashok Mehta committee, GVK RAO committee, LM SINGHVI committee, THUNGON committee, GADGIL committee report on Panchayati Raj. And finally, we will see that on the basis of this GADGIL committee report, 73rd Constitutional Amendment Act of 1992 will be brought in, friends. However, 73rd Amendment Act of 1992 will contain provisions which were detailed in other committees also. So all of these things will be taking up, friends. So this is presented by me. If you want to follow me, the link of my Instagram profile is given in the description box below, friends. Also, this video is in English. If you want to follow, you want to see the Hindi version of the video, the link of it is also given in the description box. So let's start with this, friends. Ashok Mehta committee, it was formed in December 1977 by the Janata government. Okay, its chairman was Ashok Mehta. It submitted its report in August 1978. It made 132 recommendations, friends. So it said this three-tier system of government has to be replaced with a two-tier system. And the new two-tier system will have a Zilla Parishad at the district level. And below the Zilla Parishad, there will be a Mandal Panchayat. And that Mandal Panchayat will have a group of villages and which have a combined population of 15,000 to 20,000. So only two tiers will be there according to Ashok Mehta. Then it said that district will be the first and main point of decentralization. And from it, popular supervision will be done. Zilla Parishad will be an executive body. Okay, friends, and it also said that all political parties will take part in the elections of the Panchayat because through this only the Panchayat elections can be made more famous and the appeasement of people would be started by the politicians at the basic level also, so that will empower the people. Also, it is said that Ashok Mehta committee said that these Panchayati Raj institutions, they should be given the power to levy their own taxes so that they can arrange their own finances, because for running any particular thing, finance is the most important thing. We all know about it, friends. It also said that a district level agency will be established which will do regularly the social audit, friends. Okay. And this social audit will see that whatever finances are being spent by them, are they spent in a logical manner or they are being wasted away. So this thing will also be seen, friends. Okay, and it was said that Nyaya Panchayats will act separate as then the development panchayats. Now, what was basically this Nyaya Panchayat, friends? What happened that when this Balwant Rai committee was accepted, the report was accepted in December 1958 by the National Development Council, lots of states established Nyaya Panchayats, friends. But actually, the work of these Nyaya Panchayats to give judicial declarations for the people living in the villages. So this was a function of Nyaya Panchayats. They were not exactly development panchayat. So this Ashok Mehta committee said that development panchayat should function separately than the Nyaya Panchayat, because the work of Nyaya Panchayat is different from the work of a development panchayat. And this is basically this Panchayati Raj system. This is basically performing the development functions. Nyaya Panchayat, in their term, should be, headed by a qualified judge. Also, important provisions with relation to elections, Panchayati Raj elections, were also detailed in it, friends. Okay. Also, friends, it was being said that in the State Council of Ministers, in the State Legislative Assembly, there will be a Minister of Panchayati Raj, which will look over the Panchayati Raj institutions, so a separate portfolio would be given in it. It is also said the reservation for the seats of scheduled caste or scheduled tribes, it should be strictly on the basis of population. It is said that constitutional recognition should be given to these Panchayati Raj bodies. Now, what happened is Janata government was basically a coalition government, friends. Somehow it was existing. It faded away, and when the government collapsed, Ashok Mehta committee reports or committee also became null and void. Nothing, no action was taken on the committee report. However, some states like Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, West Bengal took some steps to reform the systems because they had the discretionary power to do anything in the Panchayati Raj. Then moving forward came the GVK RAO committee. This was appointed in 1985 by the planning commission, friends. Okay. And this basically said that when it gave its report, the GVK RAO committee said that the working of this panchayat has become bureaucratized. A lot of power is given to the bureaucrats, the government servants, and basically grassroots level democracy is missing in it. This was being said by it. So it also made some recommendations in which it said that Zilla Parishad, that is the district level body, it will be the most important in the scheme of democratic decentralization, because that would be the unit of planning and development. Okay, now this Zila Parishad will give the work to the district and lower levels. Okay, and obviously the district and lower level, tiers of this Panchayati Raj, they will also play a very important role in planning implementation of the rural development programs, friends. So this will also be done. Okay, friends. And, a post of district development commissioner will be created. He will head the Zila Parishad and he will take look over all the development activities. And it said that elections at that point of time of many Panchayati Raj all over the country in many states were due. And actually they were due for many, many years, friends. So this committee said that elections should be held more regularly. They should not be held on the whims of the political executive sitting in the state legislature. Then came the LM SINGHVI committee, friends. It was adopted in 1986, appointed in 1986 by the Rajiv Gandhi government. So this also gave some. It also said that Panchayati Raj institutions should be constitutionally recognized. And it said that a separate chapter should be added for the Panchayati Raj institution. And obviously the Panchayati Raj institution, when they will be mentioned in the constitution, they should be mentioned in the constitution in such a manner that their elections, their identity, their composition, all of these things should be made mandatory through the constitution. So the constitution will safeguard their existence and not the whims of the state legislature. So this was being said by the LM SINGHVI committee. It also said that this LM SINGHVI committee also said that for a cluster of villages, Naya Panchayat should exist. That is, Naya Panchayat should not operate on a village-to-village basis. For a cluster of villages should be made and a common Naya Panchayat should be there for it, friends. And also, LM SINGHVI committee very much emphasized on the importance of Gram Sabha. Now, what is a Gram Sabha, friends? Gram Sabha is basically that body of the village in which all the members of the village who are mentioned in the electoral rolls of the village for the purpose of the Panchayat elections, that is Gram Sabha. So basically, this Gram Sabha elects the members of the Panchayats. Okay, so this Gram Sabha body is a very important body. This was being said by LM SINGHVI committee, and this body's proper functioning is very much important to safeguard this concept of direct democracy, grassroots level democracy, basic democracy. This was being told, friends. Then it was being said that more and more financial resources and independence should be given to these village panchayats. Then it was said that when Panchayati Raj institutions will function, whenever work will be done by them, friends, then obviously many controversies will arise, many problems will arise. So in order to solve those problems and controversies, judicial tribunals will have to be established in each state, friends. This was being also told, friends. Then came the THUNGON committee. Okay, so this THUNGON committee was set up in 1988 under the chairmanship of P.K. THUNGON. It also said the same things, friends. It said that Panchayati Raj body should be constitutionally recognized. There should be a three-tier system. It also emphasized on the importance of Zila Parishad, friends. It said that the Panchayati Raj body should have a tenure of 5 years. Okay. It said that if it is being suspended, then elections should be conducted within 6 months. Also, it was said, one important report of this THUNGON committee is that what if the constitutional status is given to Panchayati Raj, then what exact subjects will be included in those in that constitutional head? That should also be mentioned, friends. Then it is said that reservation to scheduled caste, scheduled tribes and to the women should be given on the basis of their population, friends. Okay. And it also said that state finance commission should be established, which will lay down the criteria, the guidelines, and will tell the principles according to which the finances will be provided to the Panchayati Raj institutions. And it said that the chief executive officer CEO will be the district collector of what? Of Zila Parishad, friends. And coming forward to our final report, friends, the GADGIL committee report. Now, this is the most important. This was under the chairmanship of V.N. GADGIL, appointed in, friends, when? Appointed in 1988. Now, this committee was the most important because this was the last committee on the basis of the report of this committee. The 73rd Amendment Act of 1992 will come in place. Now, this GADGIL committee report also said that a constitutional status should be given to Panchayati Raj institution. Then it said that a three-tier system should be established for the Panchayati Raj. That is, Panchayat should be also be at the village level, should also be at the block level, should also be at the district level. Then it said that whatever Panchayati Raj elections are being elected, they should be elected for a tenure of how much? 5 years. And it said that all the members of these Panchayati Raj institutions to be directly elected. For example, the members of the village panchayats to be elected directly by the Gram Sabha. The members of the block panchayat, that is Panchayat Samiti, to be directly elected by the members of the block, population of the block. And then the members of the Zila Parishad should be elected by the members of the district. So all of these things were being told, friends. It was said that reservation should be given to SCs, STs, women's friends. Then it said that these Panchayati Raj bodies will be given a responsibility, friends, that they will prepare the plans and they will also implement the plans for the socio-economic development of the area which comes under them. And it was said, the same thing that was said in the Thungon committee report, that a detailed list of subjects will be prepared, which will be specifically told that these will come under the, you know, powers of the Panchayati Raj. For example, friends, when I will be discussing with this 73rd Amendment Act, in this Article 243G will come. Okay, a separate schedule has been added to the Constitution of India in which 29 subjects are there, which tell us that what exact subjects are coming under the domain of Panchayati Raj institutions. So basically, this GADGIL committee report told that a list of subjects should be prepared. And it should be listed in the Constitution, which will tell that on what subjects the Panchayati Raj institutions will work. Then it said that the Panchayati Raj institution should be empowered and given the power to levy, collect, you know, appropriate and small taxes and duties. And because of that, it will get finances. And by that finances, it will become self-independent, self-able to perform its own function. Because any organization to perform, any body, any member to perform, needs some amount of resources, friends. And it also said that regularly, a state finance commission should be established. And the work of that state financial commission would be to, you know, carry out statistical studies, financial studies, and it will recommend measures that how the finances of a particular panchayat can be improved and it can be made financially independent. Then it said that a state election commission should be established, which will have the responsibility of conducting fair and transparent election to these bodies, to these panchayats, friends. So obviously these GADGIL committee reports were the final reports. And they were basically, you can say, a summary of all the previous reports that was given to us. You know, bad things were cut out, main things were included. And finally, this became the basis for drafting an amendment bill. And this amendment bill in future will transform itself to 73rd Amendment Act of 1992, which will bring in the Panchayati Raj institution, friends. So I hope this thing becomes clear to you, friends. Now, this video is not very important, friends. Just told you an idea. I don't think so that this will be a big importance to you. However, the very next video, the 73rd Constitutional Amendment Act of 1992, please watch that video with detail, because that video is very, very important. So thank you for watching my video, friends. Have a great day. Goodbye. Take care. And please subscribe to my channel, friends. Like this video. It takes a lot of effort to make these sort of videos. And share and comment. And please share these videos more and more on your Instagram profile, social media profile, and to your friends.